Please see the link in the description if you wish to download a free video worksheet on gravity. Experiments can be dangerous. If you are a child, never do experiments unless your parent, guardian, or adult educator says it's all right and is there with you the whole time. This man is about to drop a hammer and a feather. Which do you think will land first and why? In slow motion replay, we can see that the hammer landed first. If you said the hammer will land first because it is heavier, then would you expect the 50-pound weight that the man is holding to land before the 5-pound weight that the lady is holding? The 50-pound and 5-pound weight land at the same time. This teaches us our first lesson about gravity. Gravity pulls all objects down at the same speed per second. That means heavy and light objects are pulled down at the same speed per second. But if gravity pulls all objects down at the same speed per second, then why did the feather fall slower than the hammer did? To answer that question, let's do an experiment with these toy skydivers that are equal weight, but only one will have a parachute open. Which do you think will land first and why? The skydiver with the parachute closed landed first. The feather and the skydiver with an open parachute fell more slowly than the other objects. That's because the slower objects were slowed down by the air more than the faster objects were. That's because they had more air resistance. This teaches us our second lesson. Air resistance slows objects down, so they fall slowly. Objects with high air resistance may fall slower than objects with low air resistance. The ideal way to confirm whether air resistance is causing the feather to be slowed down more than the hammer would be to drop the hammer and feather someplace where there is no air. That way, there would be no air or air resistance, so we should see the hammer and the feather land at the same time. The moon has no air, so that would be the perfect place to drop a hammer and a feather at the same time.
Well, in my left hand, I have a feather. In my right hand, a hammer. And I guess one of the reasons we got here today was because of a gentleman named Galileo a long time ago who made a rather significant discovery about falling objects in gravity fields. And we thought that where would be a better place to confirm his findings than on the moon. And so we thought we'd try it here for you. The feather happens to be appropriately a falcon feather for our falcon. And I'll drop the two of them here, and hopefully they'll hit the ground at the same time. How about that?
This moon experiment confirms several facts. Gravity pulls all objects down at the same speed per second. If there is no air like on the moon, then all objects will fall at the same speed per second. If there is air, like on the Earth, then the objects with high air resistance, like a feather, will fall slower than the objects with low air resistance, like a hammer. Gravity affects all objects, animals, and people. Gravity on Earth pulls objects towards the center of the Earth. Gravity does not pull things to the north, south, east, or west. It only pulls things straight down. Unless there is significant air resistance, gravity makes people, animals, and objects fall faster if the amount of time they fall gets longer. This man is jumping off a high cliff. His speed is shown in miles per hour. Please notice how his speed continues to increase. That means that the longer he is falling, the faster he will fall. Gravity has a very long range. It can reach farther than many billions of miles. Our sun's gravity is very strong. The sun's gravity is the reason why all the planets in our solar system, including the Earth, orbit the sun. Without the sun's gravity, the planets would fly off to other parts of the universe. When two very large objects are close to each other, like the moon is close to the Earth, their gravitational fields can affect each other. For example, the Earth's pull on the moon keeps the moon orbiting around the Earth, and the moon's pull on the Earth's oceans cause the oceans to rise or fall, depending on how close an ocean is to the moon. In this sped-up video, we can see the ocean is rising. It is going from low tide to high tide. We can see the sunlight is fading, which reminds us that the Earth is always rotating. When an ocean is on the surface of the Earth that has rotated such that it is now facing the Moon, like is happening in this video, then the Moon's gravity pulls that ocean towards it, which makes a high tide. There is no such thing as an anti-gravity machine or anti-gravity powers. If we see an animal or a machine that is not falling, there are many possible reasons to explain that, and we will learn about those as we study more science. But the explanation is never anti-gravity powers or machines. For example, this plane is flying about 5 miles above the ground, but the people are pulled to the floor of the plane in just the same way as if they were walking inside a building on the ground. You may have seen videos of astronauts who appear to float inside the space station and wonder if there is gravity inside the space station. The answer is yes. Gravity affects the space station, but the gravity is easier to see from outside the space station. From the outside, we can see the Earth's gravity is keeping the space station orbiting close to the Earth. The space station can go around the entire Earth in 90 minutes. It's moving at over 15,000 miles per hour. Gravity affects all of us, all of the time. Knowing how gravity affects the weight of objects helps engineers use the right materials and right designs when making everything from small bridges in the country to huge skyscrapers in the city. Here's a summary of this video's introduction to gravity. Please pause the video if you wish. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.